video, we will understand what is the CRISPR-Cas9 system and how it is used for genome editing. Scientists did not really invent the CRISPR-Cas9 system. Instead, they borrowed it from bacteria and archaea. When a virus infects a bacterium, it injects its DNA into the bacterium. The viral DNA gets inserted into the bacterial genome and creates multiple new viral particles which lyse the bacterial cell and move out to infect other hosts. Earlier, it was unknown that prokaryotic forms like bacteria can have an immune memory or an immune system. Now, the scientists have discovered that bacteria can defend itself against the virus using the CRISPR-Cas9 system. CRISPR is the short for Clustered Regularly Interspaced Short Palindromic Repeats. These are DNA sequences derived from viruses. And there are two main components of the CRISPR-Cas9 system, the Cas9 protein and the guide RNA. The Cas9 protein is a nuclease, that is a molecular scissor that can cleave nucleotide sequences. The guide RNA, as the name suggests, guides the Cas9 protein to make a specific cut. This guide RNA can bind to a complementary DNA sequence, after which the Cas9 nuclease makes the cut. We will look at the mechanism later. So, when the virus injects its DNA into the bacteria recognizes the viral DNA due to the presence of DNA markers, that is PAM, protospacer-adjacent motifs. Cas9 enzyme finds the complementary sequences in this viral DNA, bind to it and cleaves the viral DNA. The bacteria inserts a part of the cleaved viral DNA into its own genome. So the next time when the same virus comes in, the bacteria will quickly respond and cut the viral DNA using the Cas9 protein. This is how the bacteria preserves a memory of the invading virus. During its lifetime, the bacteria comes in contact with many viruses, so it creates a hit list in its genome. The hit list contains short 20 nucleotide sequences from the viral DNA, and this hit list is known as CRISPR. CRISPR family consists of DNA containing short repetitive palindromic sequences. After each of this repetition, the bacteria inserts a small part of the viral DNA called the spacer viral DNA. These spacer viral DNA are used to detect and destroy DNA from similar virus during subsequent infection. Scientists modified the CRISPR-Cas system of bacteria and archaea to edit genomes. Mainly Cas9 protein is extracted from S. aureus or S. pyogene. S. aureus Cas9 proteins are smaller than S. pyogene Cas9 proteins. Both of them have similar on-target effects. However, S. aureus Cas9 has lesser off-target effects. Scientists first select a gene they want to target and then they design a short synthetic guide RNA which consists of two parts, a complementary 20 nucleotide sequence for the target DNA and a scaffold sequence that can bind to the Cas9 protein. The target site can be easily modified by changing the complementary spacer sequence in the guide RNA. A plasmid vector is created to synthesize the Cas9 and the guide RNA complex inside the desired cell. The plasmid vector generally consists of a promoter, Cas9 sequence, a selectable marker, and origin of replication, the target DNA complementary sequences, and the guide RNA scaffold that will bind to the Cas9 protein. As the plasmid is expressed, Cas9 protein and guide RNA are synthesized. The Cas9 protein has a positively charged groove that attracts the negatively charged nucleotide sequences in the guide RNA scaffold, forming a ribonucleoprotein complex. Cas9 protein undergoes a conformational change after guide RNA binding and becomes active. In its active form, Cas9 can now bind to DNA sequences. The guide RNA binds to the complementary target DNA of the host cell in the 3' to 5' direction. After binding to the target site, Cas9 undergoes a second conformational change, which exposes the nuclease domains RUKV and HNH to cleave the opposite strands of the target DNA, leading to a double-stranded break with blunt ends. The resulting double-stranded break is then repaired by one of the two general repair pathways, the efficient but error-prone non-homologous end joining pathway or the less efficient but highly fiddlant homology-directed repair pathway. The repair can result in amino acid deletion, insertion or frameshift mutation, which ultimately leads to a loss of function of the target gene. Thus, genes can be efficiently silenced using the CRISPR-Cas9 system. It is, however, widely used to create knockouts. A modified version of the Cas9 can be used to activate the gene instead of silencing it. As we know, RUKV and HNH do not have any role in target site binding. They play a role in cleavage. Thus, researchers inactivated the two domains by point mutation to create a modified nuclease, dead Cas9, which cannot cleave the target DNA. The dCas9 molecule can now be fused to any activating domain to express a particular gene, or it can be fused to glean fluorescent protein to visualize genes in live cells using fluorescent microscopy. As we saw, there is a two-step control on Cas9 mediated cleaving. The binding to the guide RNA scaffold activates the DNA binding ability of Cas9 protein, and the binding of the target DNA activates the DNA cleaving ability. Thus, CRISPR-Cas system is quite efficient at targeting the correct genome. However, off-target effects may be seen. Off-target effects can be avoided by using softwares to check the similarity of the target sequence to other sites in the target genome and by selecting a specific guide RNA. CRISPR genome editing tool allows scientists to quickly create cell and animal models which researchers can use to accelerate researches in diseases such as cancer and mental illness. Researchers can even use the technique to edit plants to either increase the yield or make them resistant to pesticides, increase shelf life, or add nutritive ingredients. In addition, the CRISPR technology is now being developed as a rapid diagnostic tool. CRISPR technology has been applied for treating some genetic disorders as well. If this video was helpful, then please like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to leave us your valuable comments. Thank you.